Hello guys and welcome to our YouTube channel Scratch Learners. Today we will see the timing diagram of MVI instruction. So we have already discussed the timing diagram of opcode fetch cycle, memory read and IO read and write machine cycles, right? Now we will be understanding the timing diagram of the instructions. So all these instructions uses a combination of opcode fetch cycle, memory read and write cycle and IO read and write cycle. Here we are taking MVI instruction, MVI B, C6 hex. I hope you know the use of MVI B instruction. This instruction will move the data C6 hex into the register B. That means simply the B register will be loaded with C6 hex data. And this MVI B, C6 hex instruction is of 2 byte. We have already discussed in a video which instructions are 1 byte, 2 byte and 3 byte instructions. So you can refer to that video by checking it in the I button. So this one is a 2 byte instruction, as the first byte will be the opcode of MVI B instruction and the opcode of MVI B instruction is 06 hex. And the second byte will be occupied by this data that is to be loaded, that is C6 hex. Alright, let's say we are executing this instruction at some address C050 hex. Okay, so 06 hex is being stored in C050 hex address and the second byte will be occupied in the C051 hex address. Hence, this is a 2 byte instruction. The first byte is this one and the second byte is this one. So this is the address, this is the mnemonics and this is the opcode. That means here the first byte, that is 06 hex, represents the opcode for loading a byte into the register B. And the second byte is the data that is to be loaded into the register B. Alright. So the 8085 macro processor needs 2 machine cycles to read these 2 bytes from memory. The first machine cycle will be the opcode fetch cycle. Okay, and the second machine cycle will be memory read cycle. I hope you all know that before starting the execution of any instruction, first of all, we need to fetch the opcode, which represents what instruction is going to be performed. And here the second machine cycle is the memory read. Why? Because this data is going to be read from the memory into the microprocessor. And if you have seen my video on the timing diagram of opcode fetch and memory read machine cycles, there you could have seen that opcode fetch cycle needs 4 T states and the memory read cycle needs 3 T states. Okay. So in total, MVI instruction will be using 4 plus 3, that is 7 T states. If you are having any problem in understanding about opcode fetch and memory read cycle, you can watch those videos by getting the link from the I button. Now we will be drawing the timing diagram of MVI instruction where the code 06 hex is fetched from the memory location C050 hex and the operand C6 hex will be fetched from C051 hex address. So here there are 2 machine cycles. M1 is for opcode fetch and M2 is for memory read machine cycles. And there are 4 T state in opcode fetch and 3 T state in memory read instruction. First of all, I have drawn the clock pulses as usual. Then we will move towards the higher order address lines. In opcode fetch cycle, we have seen that T1, T2 and T3 contains the higher order address line, but the T4 will remain unspecified as the higher order address will be required in the read, fetch and decode cycles, but not during the execution. So T1, T2 and T3 will contain the higher order address bits and the T4 will remain unspecified. See here, the higher order address is C0 hex, so it will be containing C0 hex, that is the higher order address. Okay, and this region will remain unspecified. Then for memory read, the higher order address will be required for all the 3 T states, because here there is no 4th T state for execution. We only need to read some data from the memory. So for reading any data, we need to specify the higher order address. Alright. So the memory read cycle will contain the same higher order address, that is C0 hex. And while explaining the opcode fetch cycle, I have said that this is a cross-like structure because any address is a combination of zeros and ones. Now, for the multiplexed address and data lines, the first T states of both opcode fetch and memory read cycle will contain the lower order address, while these states will contain the data that is to be fetched. So in the first T state of opcode fetch, it will contain the lower order address, that is 50 hex. So it will look like this. And in T2 and T3, AD0 to AD7 lines will act as data lines, and it will contain the opcode that is to be fetched, that is 06 hex. So hence in T1 state, this will act as address bus, and it will be loaded with the lower order address bus, that is 50 hex. And here in T2 and T3, this will work as data lines, so it will be storing the opcode, that is 06 hex. Now the same thing will work for memory read cycle. T1 will be storing the lower order address, and then T2 and T3 will be storing the data. And here you can see that this is a memory read instruction. We have already fetched the opcode. So what we need to fetch next? We will fetch this data that is to be loaded. And this is being taken from the lower order address 51 hex, right? So it will be written here as the data is read from the memory having the lower order address as 51 hex. And what is the data that is to be loaded? It is C6 hex. So how will microprocessor load the data? It will take the higher order address from here, C0 50 hex. That is this address. And from this address, it will load this data. See here, that is the opcode. Similarly, for memory read, it will go to C0 51 hex address. That means here. And it will take the input C6 hex, that is the data to be loaded. Now comes the ALE, that is the address latch enable. So we all know when ALE is high, then AD0 to AD7 lines will act as address lines. And here you can see in T1 and here in T5, these AD0 to AD7 lines are storing the lower order address, that is they are acting as address bus. So ALE will be high during T1 and it will also be high during T5, that is the first T state of memory read cycle, and then it will remain low. The next one is IOM bar S1 and S0 signal. So there is a specific value for both opcode fetch and memory read instructions, right? So we will write it here and here. If you refer to the chart of control signals, then you will see that during opcode fetch cycle, IOM bar is equals to 0, S1 equals to 1, and S0 equals to 1. But during memory read cycle, IOM bar will be 0, S1 will be 1, and S0 will be 0. So these are the corresponding values. Now the last one is the RD bar signal. Now here you can see that a data is to be read from T2 and T3 and T6 and T7, because see, 06 is the opcode that is to be read and C6 is the data that is to be read from the memory. So the RD bar signal will remain low during T2 and T3 states and also during T6 and T7 states, because see, RD bar is an active low signal. So when it becomes low, it actually means that a data is to be read. So when here RD bar is becoming low, it will take the input this data and it will remain low until the input is taken. Similarly here, this RD bar signal will become low during inputting the data. So this is how a timing diagram of MVI B instruction looks. If you want to modify it, like you have MVI C, some data, then what you need to do? We need to write the opcode of MVI C instruction here, and whatever data you need to fetch, you will write this in this place. Okay, and the whole process will remain same. And if you want to change the memory address from where you want to take the input, so just write the higher order address here and the lower order address here. So I hope you understood this timing diagram. If you are having any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. And if you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. In the next videos, we will discuss more timing diagrams on move instruction, STA, and many more. So see you in the next video. Thank you.